a little introduction on myself before I start the presentation. So my name is Etienne. I'm French, based in Madagascar. I'm working for ECOCERT. ECOCERT is a certification body, worldwide leader in organic certification, but we also do fair trade certification and other sustainable standards, mainly on agriculture, but we can also provide you with consultancy if you need advice regarding how to start your sustainable farming or sustainable sourcing for your company. ECOCERT is a worldwide leader of organic agriculture. We are 30 years old now, because it has, like my age, because it has started in 1991. And we are in Africa since 1995 with our first subsidiary in Madagascar. And today we have 5 subsidiaries in Africa: Madagascar, ECOCERT Madagascar, ECOCERT South Africa, ECOCERT Burkina Faso, ECOCERT Tunisia, and that's it. So it's 4, not 5. But we cover the whole Africa with our certification body to provide you with our services. So now I'm going to start the presentation. You can ask questions in the chat during the session. I will answer it the best that I can. And at the end of the presentation, we will have also a little question and answer. So don't hesitate to ask your question. I will be delighted to answer them.
This module details the rules and steps to apply when exporting organic products to Europe.
So as you can see, there will be 3 different parts. The first one will be identify which rule applies to your situation. Second will be know the different steps. And the third will be deal with transaction certificates. So let's start with the first module.
The EU organic regulation sets organic rules common to all countries in the European Union. A business trading within the European Union has the right to export and import goods freely. The right of free trade also includes the right of free transit throughout the territory of the EU. Once a product, even one manufactured outside the European Union, has entered the EU, it can be transported freely within the EU. Therefore, a company located in the European Union can sell its organic products to other companies in the EU simply using an organic certificate. No need of a transaction certificate.
Sorry. So once a product enters Europe, then it can go freely from one country to another. So let's imagine a product enters France, then it will travel everywhere else within Europe without any restriction. But there will be a control when entering Europe. So, and this is what we are going to see today, how to export to Europe. So how to pass this control to enter Europe and then to move freely within Europe. So what you have to know is when talking about organic certification, there is a legislation, a regulation that applies. It is the EU for European legislation, regulation that apply. And what you need to know as well is that we are currently switching to a new regulation. So we are going to see the current one that applies till 2023. And I'm going to talk about the new one that will be applied from 2023, which will be the regulation. So let's take a look at the current regulation regarding how to export to Europe.
For now, only companies located in the European Union can be certified against the EU regulation. This regulation is currently not applicable in third countries.
Indeed, Europe makes a difference between European countries and third countries. Third countries is any other country outside Europe. It is a third country. So today, with the current legislation, you can certify the EU only when it's inside Europe. When it's outside Europe, you can certify it as per an equivalency for third countries. This is with the current regulation. However, this will change with the new regulation in 2023.
Let's take that attention. The 2021 EU regulation coming into force before 2023 will make this situation change. In the future, it will be possible to perform audits and certification according to the EU regulation in third countries. The European Commission will establish a list of certification bodies authorized to do so.
Okay, so the only difference is because today, you see, we can already certify organic product, for example, from Madagascar to be exported to Europe, but we certify as per an equivalency. The equivalency is called EOS, EcoCert Organic Standards. But from 2023, we will be able to directly certify as per organic EU. This is a bit technical. This is not maybe very important for you, but it's always good to know about it, even if it you can still today be certified in Africa as organic and export to Europe. Okay, so now it's a little case study, I guess, how to export organic product to the EU. So let's check with the current regulation and let's have a look with the new regulation coming into force in 2020.
Export to Europe can be made through two types of equivalents. First, the European Commission accepts as equivalent the organic national regulations of different countries. Second, the European Commission accepts as equivalent different CB regulations. These regulations are set by accredited certification bodies around the world. As example, EcoCert created its own organic regulation called EOS for EcoCert Organic Standard.
So, as you can see, there is two kinds of certification outside of Europe when you want to certify the organic product. Either the country is equivalent. For example, if I take the United States of America, they have their own organic standard called NOP, and NOP is equivalent to Europe. So if you are in the US and you certify your orange, you can export it to Europe without being certified organic EU, because there is an equivalency that applies. However, this number of countries are very limited, and there is only one in Africa, it's Tunisia. If you are certified according to the Tunisian organic national law, then you can export to Europe. But this is the only country in Africa. For all other countries, you have to go through EcoCert, for example, and get an EOS certificate, EcoCert Organic Standards. But other certification body in Africa have their own organic standards that is recognized by the EU to be able to export to EU. Yeah. Don't hesitate to ask questions in the chat. Meantime, I can answer it at the end of every slide. So please don't hesitate. So this is for the current legislation. And let's take a look for the new regulation.
In the new regulation, there will be two systems to import organic products from third countries. The system of equivalent countries will remain, but where there is no possible country equivalence, the CB regulation system will be replaced by direct certification against the EU regulation.
So the only difference with the current regulation, it is that we won't certify as per an equivalency, EOS. We will directly certify as per the EU legislation. That's it. That's the only difference regarding the new regulation that is coming into force on how to export organic products to the EU.
Oops, George has been called into a meeting. Can you help Carmen answer the question?
So how many countries' regulation have been accepted as equivalent by the European Commission so far? So this you can't know it because we haven't seen it yet. However, me, I know the answer because yesterday I displayed this module in French, because otherwise, to be fair, I don't know every organic rules by heart, even if I'm working for EcoCert. So here, the answer is 13. There is only 13 countries worldwide accredited to accepted as equivalent by the European Commission. We are going to have a look at them. And you will see that Tunisia, as I said, for Africa, is part of it. So this means that if you live in one of those countries, Canada, US, Argentina, Chile, Costa Rica, India, Japan, Korea, Australia, New Zealand, Tunisia, Israel, and Switzerland, and you are certified as per their national organic standards, you can directly export to the EU without any need to be certified organic EU, because they recognize each legislation as equivalent to their to Europe legislation. However, if you are in Madagascar, like we are here, and you want to export to Europe, you will need an EOS certificate, EcoCert Organic Standard, or if you go through another certification body that is recognized by the EU, you will need their organic standard, their organic certification, in order to be able to export to Europe. And the EcoCert, we are based in Madagascar. We have an office in Madagascar, but also in South Africa, Burkina, and Tunisia, like I said earlier, and we cover all Africa. So if you need to be certified in different African countries, we can come, carry an audit, and deliver a certificate so that you can export to the Europe. So an EOS certificate, EcoCert Organic Standard.
For an exporter, the type of equivalence he shall use will depend on his country. If he is exporting from one of the 13 equivalent third countries, he will normally export through the first system. If he is exporting from another country, he will normally export through the second system. For these 13 countries, the scope and conditions of equivalencies are listed in the regularly updated Annex 3 of the ECE regulation number 1235/2008. For each concerned country, this annex enumerates special requirements regarding the origin of products and ingredients, the categories of products which are included in the equivalence, as well as the certification bodies which are recognized.
Okay, so this is a little bit technical, but as I said, when you are one in one of these countries, that is recognized by the EU, then you can export directly to Europe. However, if you are in the second system that we are going to see now, let's see how to do it.
For these CBE private standards, the scope and conditions of the equivalencies are listed in the regularly updated Annex 4 of the ECE regulation number 1235/2008. In this annex, the approved products categories are specified for each certification body and country.
Okay, so this is a different annex to know. So when you are in Madagascar, for example, and you want to export to EU, you need to check in the Annex 4 of the regulation to see the product you are willing to export, for example, vanilla. Is it covered by the annex? And which certification body can do the job to certify your product? However, no, don't worry. Most of the time, the certification body is doing this job for you, because this is too technical for our operators. So most of the time, they will call me. They will say, "Hey, look, Etienne, I'm looking forward to export my vanilla to Europe. Is it possible to export vanilla, organic vanilla, to Europe?" And me, I will check the product category, I will check in the annex if it's possible, and I will tell the client, yes, you can do it. We just need to perform an audit and certify your product, and then you can export to Europe. So technical work, you don't have to take care of it, because it's too technical most of the time for the operators. Us, as a certification body, we will take care of it and we will provide you with the answer. Okay, now, so we are going to have a look at the different products, categories you can export that are listed to be able to export to Europe. Hi, Philippe, thank you for your question. I'm going to answer this question at the end of this slide. First, I'm going to check the categories. So we usually divide the categories into six different categories. And there is unprocessed plant products. So for example, vanilla. Vanilla is an unprocessed plant product that can be exported to the EU. There is live animal or unprocessed animal products. So this will be, for example, meat is processed, but it should be honey, for example. This is a category B. Then there is unprocessed agricultural product and algae. To be fair, we don't do at Ecocert the aquaculture. However, you can have aquaculture certified as organic. For example, in Madagascar, we do a lot of shrimp. Madagascar is producing a lot of shrimps, red shrimps. It is a very good quality exported to Europe, and it can be certified organic. At Ecocert, we don't do it, but other certification body can do it because aquaculture is quite complex. And we have choose to focus on agriculture product rather than aquaculture. Then you have the processed agricultural product for use as food. So this is meat, for example, meat. Then there is a processed agricultural product for use as feed. And this is agricultural product to feed cows or sheep or any kind of élevage. I don't have the English word, but the product that I use as feed. And finally, you have the vegetative propagating material and seed for cultivation. So I'm going to answer the question now because the other little items here are not very interesting. So how the audit is carried out? So what we do, first, we will send you an application form where you will list, you will describe your activities. So I will take the example of a vanilla producer in Madagascar. So it will fill the form. It will say, okay, I'm working on 5 acres. I'm working with 10 producers in this region, and I'm doing processing because I need to cure the vanilla. So you will send us this information. Us, we will prepare a quotation for a visit, for an audit. Then we send the quotation. Once it is signed, we can start to the audit. So we will assign one of our auditor to go on site. And then what our auditor is going to look at, mostly is going to take a look at two things. First, it is the agricultural practices. So we check that the producer, they are not using like non-authorized fertilizer, because in organic agriculture, the number of fertilizer that you are using are limited. It must be accepted for organic agriculture. Same, you shouldn't use any pesticides that are chemicals. So this, it will check that the producer are having the right agricultural practices. This is the first thing. And the second thing that they are looking at, it is the traceability. So traceability is very important because we need, like for example, this vanilla, when it will be exported to Europe, if we take a batch of vanilla, we should be able to track it back to the crops where it has been growing. And we should be able to have also the harvest date and so on. So the traceability is very important. You need to keep a track of when did you apply fertilizer on the crops? When did you harvest the vanilla? At what time it has been processed? It went to which batch number? At what time it has been exported and so on? So this is all the traceability. And this is what we will take a look at, that the traceability is good. And once you have you pass these agricultural practices that are compliant, and plus the traceability that is good, traceability, then we can issue the organic certificate. So agricultural practices, traceability. These are the two most important things. So thank you, Philippe, for your question. Appreciated. This is my answer. And how can you prove the agriculture has used the right fertilizer while you were not around? Actually, we ask question. So I mean, we will interview the producer. So first of all, we have the knowledge of the crops. So we know what people do usually, and therefore we know what is used from what is not used. Then we will ask the, we will interview the different producer, ask them what kind of fertilizer did they use to make sure that they are compliant. And so you will tell me that then they can answer pretty much whatever they want, and they can lie, and we won't know. But also, we take samples of the vanilla. We keep samples for analysis purpose. We don't always do analysis, but most of the time, when the products arrive to Europe, the buyer, the importers, they do analysis on the product, and if they found residue of non-authorized products, they must tell us immediately, so they will do it because it's mandatory. And then if for example, you have used glyphosate or any kind of fertilizer that is not authorized, then we have the analysis of it. And then this is bad for you because it means that there have been a problem, and we will then carry a complementary audit to make sure, to understand where the issue come from and to find the issue. Okay. How can you prove? Okay. Hello, Etienne. Does Equacert provide a group organic certification for cashew nut? So yes, we provide organic certification for cashew nut for grower group as well. Kinabio managed to have organic certification for the with Kiwa. Yeah, Kiwa and Kiwa BSS. Yes, I know. So you have mostly five major certification body in Africa. You have Equacert. Us, you have Kiwa BCS, there is also Ceres, Control Union, and CCPB. So they are the main one accredited to carry organic certification audit, and therefore we recognize each other. So if you are certified for Kiwa BCS, for us you have a valid organic certificate because Kiwa BCS is, even if we are competitors, we recognize the work of each other because we work all together towards a sustainable world to comply, to make sure our operators comply with organic legislation. Anyway, but we would like to have farmers in Guinea-Bissau as their cashew nut certified. What are the procedures and what are the costs? That's a good question. The procedure, I can send it to you. So earlier I explained you a little bit. So we will send you an application form that you will have to fill. Once you have filled this application form and return it to us, we prepare a quotation that you will have to sign. Once the quotation is signed, we'll mandate an auditor to carry the audit. And once the audit is done, so we will check the traceability and the cultural practices. And if you are compliant, then we issue the certificate. So from the date of the audit, you can expect the certificate to be issued roughly 1 or 2 months after the end of the audit, depending on your compliancy, of course. Because if your producer has used pesticides, then don't expect us to certify your product. I mean non-authorized pesticides, because some of them are authorized by the organic regulation. So if it's authorized, it's okay. What are the costs? It will depend on the size of your project, but I'm going to talk about it a little bit later. Otherwise, we are going to be late on the presentation, so I'm going to move forward. And I'm going to come back to all your questions. Thank you, all of you, by the way, to ask questions because it makes this more interesting. And yeah. Please don't hesitate to keep on asking questions, and I will answer all of them at the end. Yeah, that's it. So let's see the different steps in order to get the certificate to export to Europe, just to explain you. Blah, blah, blah. What are the different steps I need to follow if I want to export to Europe? Yeah, then it's perfect. It answers your questions. We are going to answer your questions. So, Philippe, no, sorry. Pili Rani. Fred, so I'm going to call you Fred. So Fred, this is going to answer your question with a case of...
Have a look at the instructions left by George and help Carmen answer the questions.
So you see, this is there is an American branch, so based in America, of course, in Florida. They have Orange certified as per NOP. NOP is the organic standard for the US. When you are certified organic for US, the US, it's called NOP. This is the name of the certificate, NOP. So they are Orange is certified NOP. They want to export to the US. What is the first step they should do? Either they prepare the document before export, so the transaction certificate, I will talk about it a little bit later, or they need to check whether the US is listed as an equivalent country, or they need to know if ECOCERT is listed as an equivalent CB. So what we have seen earlier is that when you are certified in a country, organic, you need first to check if the country is listed as an equivalent country. So this is response B. Congratulations. Woohoo! Good answer. So the answer, yes, they should first determine whether their country is listed as equivalent. And it is the first step in order to export to the US. So look, US is listed as an equivalent country, yes. Then that's are the condition of country equivalence is met? Yes. Then you can export to the EU. This is just an example. They put no as an example. Now, if you are in Madagascar, is Madagascar an equivalent country? Is listed as an equivalent country? No. So the conditions are not met. Then you need an equivalent standard of the CV, like ECOCERT. So we will deliver the EOS certificate. So where can you check it? We have seen earlier that is in the Annex 3 of EC regulation. However, don't bother with annexes of regulation. Just ask your CB because you will have a dedicated client officer like me that will solve all your issues. So you will just call me. You will say, hey, Etienne, I would like to know if I can export this orange to Europe, can I do it? And me, I will tell you, yes, you can, or no, you can't. But most of the time, it would be a yes, no worries. I like to please my consumer. Sorry, I answered the wrong answer again, like yesterday, because I'm not a technical guy. I'm more involved with client relationship. So when I have a technical question, I go to see my tech, and ask them the question, and then I come back to my client with the right answer. So what was the answer? Annex 3, so yes, actually it was a good answer. So I don't understand why they put that I answer wrongly. Anyway, maybe there is an issue with the module, whatever. Okay. Yes, it meets, we have seen it because the US is an equivalent country. Super. Okay. Okay, this is why when what we have seen is for the US. But now if I am in Madagascar and the country is not equivalent, then what can I do? So let's see. So it's a second case of study, and it's perfect because they take an example of an African country. So if there is a South African farmer that wants to sell his wine to the European market, and they are certified by EcoCert for EOS, what should they do?
They will first need to check whether South Africa is one of the 13 equivalent third countries. It is not the case. Only then, they will check out equivalent standards of certification bodies. Fortunately, they are certified by EcoCert SA, which is recognized by the European Commission for the EOS standard in South Africa. It is now important to make sure that the product category is covered in these CB equivalents, which is also the case. They can now consider exporting.
So as I said before, first, they need to check if South Africa is listed as an equivalent country. As you can see, it's not, because in Africa, we only have Tunisia, which is listed as an equivalent country. So they can't export directly. They will need an EOS certificate from EcoCert. EcoCert SA is listed, is approved by Europe. So when you got in Africa a certificate from EcoCert, then you can export to Europe. Since it's a case, they will be able to export. So this is the code for a project certified in South Africa, ZA Bio 154. 154 is our code for EcoCert in third countries. So for example, in Madagascar, we certify as per MG for Madagascar, Bio for organic, 154 because it's EcoCert code. If you have another CB, like earlier you talked about Kiwa, it will be ZA Bio 141. I think, I'm not sure, but I think by memory, it's 141 Kiwa code. And yes, the equivalency is met. The product category is a product D. This is what we have seen earlier, product categories. So for winery, it's a product category D, which is listed by the EU. And therefore, it is accepted to export to EU. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop here because the third part is not very interesting. This is about transaction certificate, and I'm going now to answer your question. I will just have 2 minutes on transaction certificate to explain you what it is, but we are not going to go into details because this is technical and not very interesting. Plus, what you need to do first is to be certified organic, and then you will later ask for the transaction certificate. But this is something we will already explain you when you will be in contact with us for the organic certification. Because just to briefly explain you, once you are certified organic, so let's take again my example of this vanilla farmer in Madagascar. So once he has produced his vanilla, the vanilla is certified by EcoCert because we came, we carried an audit, and we delivered a certificate. Then he has the certificate, organic certificate for his vanilla. Now he wants to export to Europe. What he will need to do, he will need to ask us for a transaction certificate, also called Certificate of Inspection, COI. So this is a bit technical, but this is what always the customs, European customs, they ask for every container labeled organic arriving into Europe. They will ask for this transaction certificate. Here at EcoCert Madagascar, we issue hundreds of certificates every day for all the exports made to Europe because we cover all Africa with our transaction certificate. And our operators, they contact us daily to export to Europe, and they need this certificate on top of their organic certificate as a proof for the customs that the container arriving to Europe is indeed organic. So this is a bit technical that you don't need to understand now, because first you need to be certified organic. And once you are certified organic, we will explain you more about transaction certificates. Otherwise, it will be too much information for today. And I'm sure that you want me to answer some of your questions first. So yeah, now I'm going to stop this little presentation. I'm going to answer all your questions one by one, because this is more interesting than the transaction certificate, believe me. And thank you for asking a question, because it makes this this presentation more interactive. And it's always good to have people interested with organic certification and organic certificates. So first, it was about the cost. So how much it costs to have to receive an audit. So what we do is it will depend on the size of your company, because not all companies have the same size, and therefore the audit can vary. The time of the audit can be different from one company to another. For example, if you are a trader, which means that you are only buying and selling organic products, you still need an organic certificate. And since you are not involved at the production level, because you already buy a product that are organic certified to sell it to Europe, then it's only an audit for trader, for buying and selling. So this is quite easy to do. It takes us less than a day to do such audit. We will still have to come to your company. We will check your documents. We will check that your suppliers, they have organic certificates. We will check that we check your invoices, and also that you are legally registered in the country, and then we will issue a certificate. And this should be roughly 500 euros. Also, please note that we always invoice, for most of the time, we invoice in the local currency. It will depend on the country, but I'm doing the transaction in euros, but it can be in the local currency. For example, in Madagascar, we invoice in ariary, which is a local currency in Madagascar. So this is for trader. Now, if you have a big company involved with cocoa, for example, and you have 1,000 farmers, so then it will need much more time for us to come, perform our audit, make sure you are compliant, and issue the certificate. And there is a basic rule to apply, because when you work with 1,000 farmers, we call it a grower group. This is a grower group. And with grower group, organic grower group, we need to audit a sample of the total number of farmers. So if you have 1,000 farmers, we need to take a sample and to interview the different farmers, so to come to their site, check what the agricultural practices, check their traceability, and once it is done, we can issue the certificate. And how to do that? To determine the sample, there is a rule to apply, which is the same for all certification body, is we do the square root of the total number of farmers. So if you have 1,000 farmers, the square root is 31. So we have to interview 31 farmers in order to deliver our certificate. And 31 farmers, usually we interview 6 farmers a day. So 31 farmers will be 5 days of audit. On top of that, we can add 1 day for the processing. So if you are working with 1,000 farmers, you can expect roughly 1 week of audit. So we will send an auditor 1 week on your site, or 2 auditors for 3 days each to cover. It was about the cost. So, and the cost for this will be much more higher, because it will be 1 week of audit. And so you can expect maybe 4,000 euros. So this is roughly, but we have a fee. I can send it to you later. Everything is detailed, and you can expect roughly the cost. Also, to receive a quotation, it's free. So if you fill an application form, you send it to me, I will issue a quotation for free, of course, so that you can have the cost. And then you can take the decision whether or not you are looking to move on with the organic certification. So this was for the cost. Now a question from As2DSec, Sir As2. How long the certification lasts? Very good questions. So certification are annual, which means that you will need an audit every year. So every year we come and perform the audit. So the cost I just talked about, you can expect this every year, because every year we have to send an auditor to cross-check that you are still compliant to the organic legislation and to issue our certificate. So it's annual. However, our certificate has 2 years validity. This is in case of if 1 year we have difficulties to carry your renewal audit because of any issue from your side or our side. For example, in COVID time, we can be late with the audit planning. Then we are sure that you can keep trading, which means that if you didn't get your renewal audit yet, you can still trade your product to Europe in order not to be penalized because we couldn't carry the renewal audit yet. However, keep in mind one audit per year. So thank you, Sir Sec, As2Sec, for your question. Do the rule apply to organic skincare? Okay, this is a very good question that I didn't precise earlier. So organic certification is only for products that can be eaten. So like, for example, so vanilla or even essential oils, you should be able to at a very low quantity. But always organic certification is only for food products. Only. So skincare is not organic. It can be certified. So the raw material of the skincare can be certified organic if it's a food product. So for example, essential oil in your skincare can be certified organic. But for skincare, there is another standard called COSMOS. I'll write it down. COSMOS. I can provide you with more information about it a little bit later, but this is organic certification for cosmetics. It's called COSMOS. And in order to get a COSMOS certificate, your raw material must be certified organic. So this is why I was talking about raw material being certified organic. Then the final product, the cosmetic, can be certified COSMOS, and you can then sell it as an organic cosmetics, which is certified COSMOS. But keep in mind, organic certification is only for food products. So thank you again for this question. It was interesting. So Sir Fred, for now we have 3,000 farmers who are in 60 groups. Wow, big project of 50 farmers each. But that's not a question. Yes, this was linked to your earlier comments. But yes, that's good. I think it's better, to be fair, to be honest, it's better to have everything dispatched into different groups, especially for the internal control system, for you, in order to control what your producers are doing. It is always better when they are segregated, because it's easier to control. And for me, this kind of setup will be easier for you to achieve the organic certification, rather than to have 3,000 farmers in one cooperative, where it is more difficult to always control everything. So this kind of setup is very good. It's for me, it's more compliant than having everything in one, and it's easier also to control for you on your side. So well done, sir. That's a good setup. Now, sir or madam, Ruth Damon, hello, good day. In your presentation, you mentioned Tunisia as the only African country that has an equivalent to third countries. Are there any plan of adding certification to other African countries? Very good questions. Actually, it's very difficult first to have an equivalent to third country. For example, Tunisia, it took them 10 years before getting this equivalency. So it's a long process. And in Madagascar, they have started it. We have helping them doing so, Ecocert, so that they can achieve this equivalency. However, since the rules will change in 2023, and there won't be an equivalence. I mean, you will be able directly to be certified as per EU without the EOS certification, but directly to Organic EU. So I don't know if it's still it's still interesting for African country to work as being equivalent. Maybe, but to be fair, I need to have more information regarding this new legislation that is going to be applied from 2023. So my answer is right now there is Madagascar that is working on getting being equivalent. Maybe there are other countries that I'm not aware of, but I don't think so. And to be fair, I don't know if it's still logical. I mean, you get my point. Since the legislation will change, we will know more in the coming months. But Madagascar is working on it, at least. Now, Sir Philip, we know that flight costs in Africa are expensive. True. And I can tell you in Madagascar also, very expensive. National flight, I mean, and also international flight. Are they including on your cost? It depends. So either we include, in terms of the cost I said earlier, it depends because to be fair, it can vary from one country to another. So most of the time, yes, we include the cost in our quotation. Otherwise, it is invoiced on the side. However, when we send you the quotation, we specify it. The cost of our auditors are not included in this quotation, so you can know it. However, we have freelance auditors in every country, so of Africa, except a few exceptions like Somaliland or I think it's the only one. But we work with a freelance auditor. Like, for example, we carry audit in Tanzania with Tanzanian auditor. In Kenya, the same. We have auditor in Congo. We have auditor in Rwanda. We have auditor in Cameroon. We have auditor pretty much everywhere. And local auditor, I mean. So you don't have to bear the cost of international travel expenses, international flights, because we have local auditor there. So this can lower the cost. How digitalization is considered on organic certification, I guess. If a cooperative has internal traceability software, are you considering it for audit? Yes, sir, we are. Indeed, this is a good question because usually we work a lot with paperwork, which is a nightmare, to be fair, especially with cooperatives that are huge. Our auditor must go through tons of paper, and this is kind of a burden, and it takes time. So we welcome any digital software that our operator could use. You know, us, we work with the system of our operators. So what I told you earlier is that we are checking the compliance to the agricultural practices and the traceability. So the digitalization will be mostly for traceability purpose. And if you are working with a software, no problem, we will adapt. What we will do is to make sure your system is working, and with your system, you will have a good traceability. So if you are working with paper, we will check your papers. If you are working with software, we will take a look at your software. No problem. So yes, and currently, to be fair, there are some software that are being developed. I know one. I will write it down. Metajoua. They are from Uganda, I think, and they are Metajoua. Metajoua. Yes, that's it. And yes, they are developing a software for the traceability for cooperative. So and they are doing good job. So I advise you to have a look. Metajoua. I need to check. I will tell you a little bit later, but I think in that. Blah blah blah. Do you have so this is the answer? Do you have auditors placed in different places in Africa, West Africa? Yes, we do. We have an office in Burkina Faso with local auditors there. We have also auditors in Ivory Coast. So in West Africa, it's not my zone, so I have a little bit more difficulties to answer everything. But yes, we have local auditors in most of the countries. And if not, we can fly auditor from Burkina or for Ivory Coast, but we tend to work with local auditors always. I know we have in Sierra Leone, I think in Guinea, I'm not sure, but most of the time we work with local auditors. So, yeah. Yep. Sir Fred, does the EcoCert ESA also include IHCCP in line with the organic certificate, or after having the bio, you need to again carry out a HCCP audit for the quality management? So these are two different certification. So for sure, with an organic certificate, it's not equivalent to HCCP certificate. Same, if you are certified HCCP, that does not mean that you are a certificate that you are certified for organic, since it's really two different certification. And therefore, what we will do it is that we can combine the audit. So if you are looking for an organic certificate and one HCCP certificate, we will send one auditor that will carry both standards at the same time in order to save you cost of travel and cost of audit time and so on. So the audit will be longer than only one organic audit or only one HCCP audit, because we will combine the two. But since it's combined, it will reduce the travel cost and you will have economy of scale by combining these two certifications. But we can do it, yes. You can also check www.agunity.com for traceability for those interested. Thank you, Sir Philippe. That's a good. That's much appreciated. Please don't hesitate to share some kind of good practices or like advice like you did. Because it's always interesting, I think, for everyone to know what's done in Africa. And yeah, that's it. So it's soon over, this presentation, because it was 1 hour. I'm going to send you my email address. Should you need any further information or have further questions, You can write an email to my email address, this one, etienne.bertelot@ecocert.com. If you are looking to get organic certification for Africa, in Africa, please send me an email, regardless of your country. If it's not the zone covered by Madagascar, I will redirect you to my colleague in charge. So my colleague from Burkina, Tunisia, or South Africa, if needed. But please write an email to me if you are looking for organic certificate. You can also add me on LinkedIn at this at Etienne Bertelot, which is my name, first name and surname. So please add me on LinkedIn as well. Yep, that's it. So thank you for your attention. It was very interesting that you ask questions. It's always more interesting. It makes the thing more convivial to like a little family to ask questions and answer. You can continue. Thank you, Nadia. You can continue to ask a question on the session. There is a question and comment box. I will answer your questions. Yesterday they asked questions on it in French because yesterday the session was in French, and I answered them. So please don't hesitate. It's always a pleasure to share our knowledge at EcoCert with our African brother, so and sister. So please don't hesitate. And there is a replay on YouTube, so you can have a look to the replay too. So thank you, everyone. It was a pleasure for me to share this with you. Again, just a closing word before ending this session. EcoCert is now 30 years old this year, and it's with more than 25 years old of presence in Africa. We have 4 offices in Africa: EcoCert Burkina, EcoCert South Africa, Madagascar, and Tunisia. We cover entire of Africa for organic certification, but also fair trade, Cosmos certification for the one that are looking to have a skincare product, for example, and other and many other sustainable standards like Rainforest Alliance and many others. So don't hesitate if you're interested to write me an email. It would be a pleasure to get in touch with you, and it would be a pleasure to answer your questions. So thanks again, everyone, and I wishing you the best for the future. And may we keep in touch in the future with your questions or with certification services. Thank you. Bye-bye, and take care.